morning, good afternoon, good evening. My name is Natalie Jewel T. De Los Santos and I'm from STEM 12. And for today's video, I will be explaining, showing some national artists for music in the Philippines. So, keep on watching!
So first, we have Antonio Molina. Antonio Jesus Molina was a Filipino composer, conductor, and music administrator. He was named a National Artist of the Philippines for his service to music. He was also known as Claude Debussy of the Philippines due to his use of impressionist theme in his music. Antonio Molina was born in Quiapo, Maynila, the son of Juan Molina, a government official who founded the Molina Orchestra. He attended the Escuela Católica de Nuestro Padre Jesús Nazareno in Quiapo, Maynila, and College of San Juan de Letran, where he was awarded in Bachelor of Arts degree in 1909. Molina made his first composition in 1912, titled Matinal, which is preserved in an unpublished volume called Miniaturas Volume 1. He was appointed to teach harmony, composition, music history, and violoncello at the UV Conservatory of Music, pursuing a career in music education until being appointed Dean of the Centro Escolar Conservatory of Music. He founded the CEU String Quartet, which was professionally organized and financed by its music school. As a composer, Molina is credited with over 500 compositions. Molina started in his interview conducted by Helen F. Sampson that his music was usually inspired by literature, which his favorite being La Novena Muestra by Rubén Darío. Antonio Molina, versatile musician, composer, music educator, was the last of the musical triumvirate to whom were Nicanor Abelardo and Francisco Santiago, who elevated music beyond the realm of folk music. At an early age, he took to playing the violoncello and played it so well, it did not take long before he was playing as an orchestra soloist for the Manila Grand Opera House. Molina is credited with introducing such as innovations as the whole tone scale, pentatonic scale, exuberance of dominant nines, and the 11 chords of linear counterpoint. As a member of the faculty of the UP Conservatory, he had taught many of the country's leading musical personalities and educators like Lucrecia Casilag and Felipe De Leon. Molina's most familiar composition is Hating Gabi, a serenade for solo violin and a piano accompaniment. Other works are of orchestral music like Misa Antonia Grand Festival Mass, Ang Batingaw Kundiman Kundangan, a chamber music Hating Gabi, String Quartet, Kung Sayo Iyong Gunita, Pandang Guhan Amihan, Awit ni Maria Clara, Larawan Nitong Pilipina. Antonio Molina received numerous awards such as a Conductor of the Year Award 1953 from the Music Lovers Society, the UP Conservatory Alumni Award, and the Phil Kappa Beta Award in 1972. Among others, he was the first musician to be conferred the National Artist in June 12, 1972. On February 15, 1895, Jovita Fuentes, dubbed the First Lady of the Philippine Music, was born in the capital town of Cavite, now as known as Rojas City. Jovita Fuentes, who received the distinction in 1976 as the first Filipina national artist in music, made a name for herself in European opera at the time when the Philippines was hardly heard of in the region. In recognition of this achievement, she was given the unprecedented award of Embajadora de Filipinas a su Madre Patria by Spain. Fuentes attended college at the University of the Philippines Conservatory of Music in 1917 and pursued her training abroad to hone and polish her skills in opera singing and acting as well. She later taught at the University of the Philippines. She was responsible for producing operas in the Philippines with dreams of developing the love opera in the country. On the count of Ovida's influence and appeal, Music Production Foundation was established through Republic Act of Number 3630, signed by the President Diosdado Macapagal, which appropriated 900,000 a year as part of the government support to the music promotion, specifically maintaining a Filipino Symphony Orchestra. Hence, she founded a various music associations such as Asociano Musical de Filipinas, the Bach Society of the Philippines, and the Arts Guild of the Philippines. Fuentes also sang the charitable organization to raise funds for the maintenance of upkeep San Lazaro Hospital, Abiertas House of Friendship, La Liga de Dasma Catolicas, Sovento de Monjas Carmelitas, and the Casa Buen Pastor. Fuentes garnered numerous other awards and citations, including Presidential Medal of Merit in Music 1950. She passed away on August 7, 1978. Long before Lea's longest break into Broadway, there was already Jovita Fuentes' portrayal of Xoxo San in Giacomo Puccini Madame Butterfly at Italy's Teatro Municipale di Pisenza. Her performance was hailed as the most sublime interpretation of the part. This is all the more significant because it happened at the time when the Philippines and its people were scarcely heard in Europe. Prior to that, she's teaching at the University of the Philippines Conservatory of Music in 1970 before leaving for Milan in 1924. For further voice studies, after 8 months of arduous training, she made her stage debuts at Piacenza. She later embarked on a string of music performance in Europa, essaying the roles of Duyo in Puccini's Turandot, Mimi in Puccini's La Boheme, Iris in Pietro Magini's Iris, the title role of Salomen, which composer Richard Strauss performerly offered to her, including the special role of Princess Yang Giuffe. In her life has been documented in the biography Jovita Fuentes, A Lifetime of Music in 1978, written by Liaida et Chung and later translated into Filipino by Virgilio Almaraz. So next, we have Honorata del Rama Hernandez, also known as Atang del Rama, was a singer and vaudeville performer who became the first Filipina film actress. Atang del Rama was born in Pandacan, Manila on January 11, 1907. By the age of 7, she was already starring in Spanish telenovelas such as Mascota, Sueña de Unvals, and Marina. At the age of 15, she started in the zarzuela Dalagang Bukid, where she became known for singing the song The Basag na Basag na during the American occupation of the Philippines. Atang del Rama fought for the dominance of the Kundiman, an important Philippine folk song, and the zarzuela, which is his musical play that focused on contemporary Filipinos' issues such as Asari, cockfighting, and colonial mentality. Generation of Filipinos, artists, and audience consider Atang del Rama vocal and acting talents as responsible for much of the success of the original Filipino zarzuelas like Dalagang Bukid and dramas like Veronida. She has also been theatrical producer, writer, and talent manager. She was produced and writer of the plays such as Anak ni Eva and Bulaklak na Kabunduan. For her achievements and contribution to the art form, she was hailed Queen of the Kundiman and the Zarzuela in 1979 at the age of Atang believed that the art should be for everyone. Not only did she perform in major Manila theaters such as Teatro Libertad and the Teatro Zorila, but also in cockpits and open plaza in Luzon, the Visayas, and Mindanao. She also made an effort to bring the Kundiman and Zarzuela to the indigenous people of the Philippines such as Igorots, the Aitas, and the Mangyans. She was also the forefront in introducing Filipino culture to foreign audience at the height of her career, she sang Condiments and other Filipino songs in concerts in such cities as Hawaii, San Francisco, Los Angeles, New York, Hong Kong, Shanghai. On May 8, 1987, for her sincere devotion to original Filipino theater and music, her outstanding artistry as singer and as zarzuela actress, playwright, producer, her tireless effort to bring her out to all sectors of the Filipino society and to the world. President Corazon C. Aquino proclaimed Atang Del Rama a national artist of the Philippines for theater and music. Atang Del Rama died on July 11, 1991. She was married to national artist for literature Amando V. Hernandez. Next, we have Antonio Buenaventura. Colonel Antonio Ramirez Buenaventura was a Filipino composer, conductor, and a teacher. Antonio Buenaventura was born on May 4, 1904 in Baliwag, Bulacan. He was born in a family of musicians. His father, Lucino Buenaventura, was a musician at the Spanish Artillery Band in Intramuros. He studied under Nicanor Abelardo at the University of the Philippines Diliman Conservatory of Music and graduated in 1932 with teacher's diploma in music, major in science and composition, and became an assistant instructor at the conservatory. He also studied composition for a postgraduate degree under and after the war, he became conductor of devastated Philippine Constabulary Band for 16 years and he brought it back to its former glory. He became the music director of the UST Conservatory of Music in 1961 and the UST School of Music and Arts in 1964. He married the violinist Rosalina X. Conde and produced 4 children. Buenaventura's music was influenced by different ethnic Philippine folk songs. In 1935, he joined Francisca Reyes Aquino in searching Philippine folk song and dances. In 1936, he composed the accompaniment to the folk dance Pandango sa Ilaw and incorporated ethnic melodies and instruments to some of his orchestra music compositions, include concert overture, prelude and fugue in G minor, Philippines Triumvirate, Mindanao Sketches, Symphony in C major, among others. Some of the awards and honors of Antonio Buenaventura is Band Conductor of the Year in 1951 from the Music Lovers Society, Republica Cultural Heritage Award for Music in 1966 for his Symphony in C, Araw ng Maynila Cultural Award in 1971, Award of Merit for Outstanding Contribution to Philippine Music in 1976 from the Philippine Army, Director Emeritus of the University of the East in 1981, National Artist of the Philippines in 1988, Doctor of Humanities in 1991 from the University of the Philippines, Diwa ng Lahi Award in 1995. Now we have Lucio San Pedro. Lucio D. San Pedro Sr. was a Filipino composer and a teacher who was proclaimed a National Artist of the Philippines for Music in 1991. San Pedro came from a family with musical roots and he became his career earlier. When he was in his late teens, he succeeded his deceased grandfather as the local church organist. By then, he had already composed songs, hymns, and 2 complete masses for voices and orchestra. After studying with several prominent musicians in the Philippines, he took advanced compositions training with Bernard Wegener of the Netherlands. He also studied harmony and orchestration under Vittorio Giani and took classes at Juilliard in 1940. His other vocation was teaching. He has taught at the Ateneo de Manila University, virtually all the major music conservatories in Manila, and at the College of Music of the University of the Philippines, Diliman, where he retired as full professor in 1978. He later received the title Professor Emeritus from the university in 1979. He also became a faculty member of the Central Escolar University Conservatory of Music in Manila. San Pedro was known for composing the official march of On May 9, 1991, President Corazon C. Aquino proclaimed San Pedro as a national artist for music. He married Gertrude San Pedro, with whom he had 5 children, Dora, Benvenido, Maria Conchita, Maria Cristina, and Lucio Jr. His orchestral music included The Devil's Bridge, Malakas at Maganda, Overture, Prelude of the Future in D Minor, Hope and Ambition, Choral Music Easter Cantata, Sa Mahal Kong Bayan, Rizal's Valedictorian Poem, Vocal Music Lulay, Sa Ugoy ng Duyan, In the Silence of the Night, and Band Music, Dance of Fairies, Triumphal March, Lahing Kayo Manggi, Agonian March, among others. His songs and ballads include Nahan Kahit na Magtiis, and Diligan Mo ng Hamog ang Uhaw na Lupa, Pilipinas, Inang Bayan, Isang Dalangin, Kalesa, Bato sa Buhangin, and Gaano Kita Kamahal. The latter song shows how Sueno has enriched the Filipino love ballad by adding the elements of condiment to it. Lucrecia R. Casilag, as a educator, composer, performing artist, administrator, and cultural entrepreneur of national and international caliber, had involved herself fully in sharpening the Filipino audience's appreciation of music. Casilag's pioneer task to discover the Filipino roots through ethnic music and fusing it with Western influence has led many Filipino composers to experiment with such an approach. She dared to incorporate indigenous Filipino instrument in orchestra, producing such as Price Takota for percussion and winds divertissements and concentrate, and the scores of the Filipiciana, Misang Pilipino, and the Prof. Buntis. Tita Kitang, as she was fondly called, worked closely as music director with colleagues Lucrecia Reyes, Urtural, Isabella Santos, Jose Labir Sidal, and Dr. Leticia B. De Guzman, and made Bayanihan Philippine Dance Company one of the premier artists and cultural group in the her orchestra music include love songs, Legend of the Sarimanok, and the Panama Philippine scenes, her son Jose, Sisa, and chamber music like Awit ng Mga Awit Psalm, Fantasies on a 4-note theme, and Ismith's Jazz Ethnica. Usually performed as communal ritual, his composition like Ugma Ugma in 1963, Pagsamba in 1968, and Udlot Udlot in 1975 are monuments to his unplugging commitment to the Philippine music. Other major work includes Agungan, Kubing, Pagsamba, Ugnayan, Ading, Aruding, Siadsid, Sulit. Felipe Padilla de Leon was a Filipino classical music composer, conductor, and a scholar. De Leon was the third of 4 children by the second marriage of his mother Natalia Padilla to Juan de Leon. His father died when he was 3 years old, leaving his mother to raise him and his older half-brother, Pedro P. Santiago. Before becoming a musician, he took various odd jobs to support his family, such as shoe polisher, carabao herder, carriage driver, and vendor of various items. In 1927, he took up fine arts at the University of the Philippines, but he had to abandon his studies to make a living. He played trombone in carabets and circus, and later worked as an assistant conductor of the Nueva Ecija High School Orchestra, where he started composing music. To improve his composing skills, he again enrolled to the University of the Philippines and graduated in 1939 with a diploma of music teacher and conductor. Much later, he continued his study under Vittori Gianni at the Juilliard School in New York, U.S. De Leon married pianist Olimada Mendoza, with whom he had 6 children, including Bayani and prominent composer and Felipe Jr. A. Wright. Their prodigious body of De Leon's musical composition, notably the sotanas, marches, and concertos, have become the full expression of the sentiments and aspiration of the Filipino in times of strifes and of peace, making him the epitome of people musician. He is the recipient of the various award and distinction: Republic Culture Heritage Award, Doctor of Humanities from UP, Rizal Pro Piatra Award, Presidential Award of Merit, Patnubay ng Kailangan Award, and among others. De Leon orchestra music include Maria McKinney Overture in 1939, Roca Encantada, Symphonic Legends in 1950, Manila Overture in 1976, Orchestra Chef Chuk in 1981, choral music like Payapang Daigdig, Ako'y Filipino, Lupang Tinubuan, Ama Namin, and songs Bulaklak, Alitaptak, and Mutya. Next, we have Jose Maceda. Jose Montserrat Maceda was a Filipino composer and ethnomusicologist. Maceda was born in Manila, Philippines, and studied piano, composition, and musical analysis at École Normale de Musique de Paris in France. After returning to the Philippines, he became a professional pianist and later studied musicology at Columbia University and anthropology at Northwestern University. Starting in 1952, he conducted fieldwork of the ethnic music of the Philippines from about 1954. He was involved in the research and composition of music concrete. In 1958, he worked at a recording studio in Paris, which specialized in music concrete. During this period, he met Pierre Boulez, Karheim Stockhens, and Ianis Senanis. In 1963, Maceda earned doctorate in ethnomusicology from the UCLA. He began pursuing compositional career more vigorous at the same time. He held concert in Manila in 1969, in which he performed and conducted this series of concerts, introduced Bose, Senasis, and Edgard Varese to the Philippines. As an ethnomusicologist, Maceda investigated various forms of music in Southeast Asia, producing numerous papers and even composing his own pieces of Southeast Asian instruments. His notable works include Pagsamba for 116 instruments, 100 mixed and 25 male boys in 1968, cassettes 100 for 100 cassettes player in 1971, Ugnayan for 20 radio station in 1974, Udlot Udlot for several hundred of several thousand people in 1975, Suling Suling for 10 flutes, 10 bamboo buzzers, and 10 flat gongs in 1985. In 1977, Maceda aimed to study Philippine folk songs, which he described as a more focus on rhythm rather than time measure. From 1990s, he also composed for Western orchestra and piano. The example as Distemperate for orchestra in 1992, Colors Without Rhythm for orchestra in 1999, Sojourn for pianos. Next, we have Levi Celerio, was a Filipino composer and lyricist who is credited with writing over 4,000 songs. Celerio was recognized as a national artist of the Philippines for music and literature in 1997. He also known for using the lyre as a musical instrument, which led to being recognized as the only man who could play music using a lyre by the Guinness Book of Records. This led to him making guest appearances in television shows recorded outside of the Philippines. Aside from being a musician, Celerio was also a poet and a film actor who appeared in various Philippine films of the 1950s and 1960s. Levi Celerio was born on April 30, 1990 in Tondo, Manila, to Sarnelio Cruz and Juliana Celerio, and was born to a poor family. Celerio's affinity for music was a result of influence from his mother, who is a harpist, and a member of church choir. He was estranged from his father, who is involved in the real estate and jewelry business. His father was never married to his mother. He also attended the University of the Philippines Conservatory of Music to study violin for 2 semesters. The director, Alexander Lipay, recommended him for a scholarship at the Academy of Music in Manila. He received scholarship and became the youngest member of the family in Manila Symphony Orchestra. Levi Salerio was a member of Manila Symphony Orchestra, but his stint with the musical troupe ended when he fell off the tree and broke his wrist. He temporarily worked as a comic illustrator and later decided to shift. Levi Salerio is credited for writing more than 4,000 songs, many of which are dedicated to his wife and children. He wrote Filipino folk, Christmas, and love song, and some of his songs were used features in films. Among original Filipino music or OPM, song he composed are Ikaw, Kahit Konting Pangtingin, San Ka Man Naroroon in 1968. He wrote the lyrics of the Filipino lullaby Sa Ugong Nanduyan. He also composed folk songs include Ako Ay May Singsing, Ang Pipit, Tungangin Mong Hirang, Itik Itik, Pitong Gatang, and Waray Waray. Sa Ugoy Nanduyan, in particular, was collaboration with Lucio San Pedro, a fellow national artist. Ang Pasko ay sumapit, officially titled Maligayang Pasko at Masaganang Bagong Taon, is an example of well-known Christmas song by Salerio, which was a Tagalog version from the original Cebuano song Kasadyay Niktak Na by Bert. Some of the awards and recognition of Levi Salerio is National Artist for Music and Literature on October 9, 1977, of President Fidel V. Ramos proclaimed him a National Artist for Music and Literature. Guinness Record, Salerio was known for using the musical instrument, which resulted in Guinness Book of World Records to recognize him as the only man who could play with lyre. Other honors award are University of the Philippines conferred him as honorary doctorate degree in humanities in 1991. The Film Academy of the Philippines gained Salerio a Lifetime Achievement Awards in 1989. He also recipient of the CCP Gawad para sa Sining in 1991 and the Gawad Orient Award in 1993. In 1950s and 1960s, Salerio was involved in various Philippine form. As a character actor, he portrayed a variety of roles which range from a beggar, a rapist, a lick your teeth, a pickpocket, and palm reader. Next national artist for music is Hernani J. Cuenco. Is a seasoned musician born in May 10, 1936 in Malolos, Bulacan. A composer, film scorer, musical director, and music teacher. He wrote an outstanding and memorable body of works that resonate with the Filipino sense of musicality and which embody an ingenious voice that raises the aesthetic dimensions of contemporary Filipino music. Cuenco played with the Filipina Youth Symphony Orchestra and the Manila Symphony Orchestra from 1960 to 1968 and the Manila Chamber Soloist from 1966 to 1970. He completed a music degree in piano and cello from the University of Santo Tomas, where he also taught for decades until his death in 1998. Next national artist for music is Andrea Veneracion. Andrea Ofiliada Veneracion was a Filipina choral conductor and recipient of the 1999 National Artist for Music Award. She founded the Philippine Madrigal Singers in 1963. She was also an educator in numerous international choral composition and was an active force in choral music before her massive stroke in 2005. Andrea Veneracion is highly esteemed for her achievements as a choir master and choral arranger. Two of her indispensable contributions in culture and the arts include the founding of the Philippines Madrigal Singers and the spearheading of the development of the Philippine Choral Music, a former faculty member of the UP College of Music and honorary chair of the Philippine Federation of Choral Music. She also organized a culture outreach program to provide music education and exposure in several provinces. Born in Manila on July 11, 1928, she is recognized as an authority on choral music and performance, has served as an educator in international music Next, we have Francisco Feliciano. Francisco Feliciano was a Filipino composer and conductor. He was a national artist of the Philippines for music. Feliciano was born on February 9, 1941 in Morong, Rizal. Francisco Feliciano graduated from the University of the Philippines with a teacher's diploma in music in 1967, with master's in music composition in 1972. In 1977, he went to the Hochschule der Künste in Berlin, Germany, to obtain a diploma in music composition. In 1979, he attended Yale University School of Music and graduated with Master of Musical Arts and Doctorate in Musical Arts Composition. While at Yale University, he conducted the Yale Contemporary Ensembles, considered as one of the leading performing groups in America for contemporary and avant-garde music. His teacher in conducting were Arthur Westberg and Martin Berman. While he studies composition under Jacob Drachmann, Isang Yun, Zimmerman, and Christoph Padecki. He died on September 19, 2014 in Manila at the age of 73. Some of works is Buksan Mo Ang Aming Mga Labi, published in 1982, Mass of St. Andrew, published in 1981, Pamugun Choral with Soprano Solo, published in 2002, Pokpok Alimpako Chorus, published in 2002, Three Visayan Fox for High Voice, published. Ramon Pagayon Santos, composer, a conductor, and a musicologist, is currently the country's foremost exponent of contemporary Filipino music. A prime figure in the second generation of the Filipino composers in the modern idiom, Santos has contributed greatly to the quest for new directions in music, taking as basis non-Western tradition in the Philippines and Southeast Asia. He graduated in 1965 from the UP College of Music with teacher's diploma and a Bachelor of Music degree in both composition and conducting. Higher studies in United States under a Fulbright scholarship in India University for master's degree in 1968 and a State University of New York at Buffalo for doctorate in 1970 exposed him to the world of contemporary and avant-garde musical idioms, the rigorous process of surrealism, electronic and contemporary music in Dirty Menasi and new vocal and improvisational techniques. He received further training in new music in Darmstadt, Germany, and Utrecht, the Netherlands. His initial interest in Marlem and Debussy while still the student of UP, at his compositional stage shifted to neoclassicism, and finally to distinguish merging the varied influences that he had assimilated. An intense and avid prodigy, Santos as chair of the Department of Composition and Theory and former dean of the College of Music, UP has remained instrumental in opposing a modern Philippine music rooted in old Asian practices and life concepts, with generation upon generation of students and teachers that have come under his wing. He continues to shape a legacy of modernity anchored on the values of tradition Asian. Lastly, we have Ryan Cayabyab or Raimundo Cipriano Pujante Cayabyab, also known as Mr. C, is a Filipino musician, composer, and a conductor. He was the executive and artist director for several years from the Juan San Miguel Foundation for Performing Arts. He was named as National Artist of the Philippines for Music in 2018. His work ranged from commissions, full-length ballets, theater musicals, choral pieces, and a masset of unaccompanied chorus and orchestra pieces to commercial recordings of popular music, film scores, and television special. Kayabyab's current project includes the Ryan Kayabyab Singers, a group of 7 young adult singers comparable to his music, Smoky Mountain, in early 1990s. After the Fremantle Media decided not to renew the Philippine Idol franchise, Kayabyab transferred to rival show Pinoy Dream Academy Season 2, replacing him, Jim Paris, as the show headmaster. He also became the chairman of the board of the judge for GMA Network's musical reality show. Some of his notable works are Ramahari, two-act musical ballet in 1980, Katida Musical, two-act musical in 1988, Smoky Mountain, Pop City album in 1990, One Christmas, Christmas album in 1993, Noli Me Tangere, Telecine musical in 1995, Spolarium, Tria opera on 2003, Ignacio of Lolaya, Loyola, film score in 2016, Larawan the musical, full-length musical film in 2017, The Coconut Nut, Kay Ganda ng Ating Musika, Nais Ko, Paraiso, Kahit Ika'y Panaginip, Kailan, Tuwing Umuulan, at Kapiling Ka. Ryan Kayabyab is a household name. His composition reflect a perspective of music that extols the exuberance of music of human happiness, thus capturing a very essence of our Filipino souls. So that's it. Thank you for watching. Hope you learned something from this video.